please. Come in.
Hi.
Hi.
We're going to have the shorter people in front. Shorter people in front. Ooh, yeah. Some of this is good for you. Some maybe wouldn't. Okay, we got everybody, Mary? Okay. Oh. Mary, is that everybody? Mary's talking.
Apparently.
Too many Marys here. Okay, I want to welcome you to behind the scenes in the small mammal building today. This area, besides being a kitchen area, is also a workers area. So if you see someone trying to come through with a wagon or something, just let them through. The keepers will prepare food back here. They also will raise animals that have maybe been abandoned by a mother. If they have a sick animal, they can keep them back here. And so they use this area for many different things. I know a lot of people, the kids come in and they go, oh, it smells and stuff in this building. That's the type of animals that are here. They're scent markers. And that's their smell that you smell when you come in and stuff. So it's nothing bad. It's just their way of going that they're here, okay? So in this building, the keepers make the diets for all the animals. Because of the big variety of animals here, they also have the biggest variety of food that gets used in this building. They use a shopping list, and the shopping list gets made out 3 times a week. It goes to the commissary, and the commissary fills the list and sends it down here. And they will send things like these produce that we have here. I mean, it's top quality food. You don't want the animals getting sick, so you're not going to give them rotten food or anything. They use veggies in their diets. They use fruits in their diet. And what they'll do is they'll make salads. This is a veggie salad that they'll give to some of the animals. This is what's called a bat salad or fruit salad. And they have to grind this up very small. And years ago, the keepers did this by hand, and it would take them like a half a day just to cut up enough food to feed the animals that would need that fruit diet. And now they have the machine that grinds it all up, so it's way less time. And that's very helpful for them because then they can take care of the animals. Now, to some of the diets that they prepare, they will add fruit juice. And, you know, especially like with the fruit-eating animals, you know, they'll put that in their diet. They use some canned food for the small monkeys that we have here. This little stuff here is a marmoset gel. This can be either a complete diet or something put into the marmoset diet that would be like a different texture or taste, because animals like humans, I think, sometimes get sick of the same taste all the time. So that's just a little bit different taste and texture for them. We use a lot of different dry food and stuff here. This is a leaf eater that they can crush up, make smaller, add liquid to it, depending on who they need to feed that to. So if it's an animal that can't crunch as much, they'll just add the liquid and make it a little bit softer. In this building, we also have a lot of meat-eating animals, okay? So we do use mice. And these are not live when they're fed to the animals. They use meat in some of the diets, fish, and they do use eggs. Now, if you were home and you dropped an egg, what would happen to it? And it makes a big mess, right? So in the commissary, they hard boil the eggs before they send them down. It's way less maintenance for the keepers to have to do, you know, if they putting raw eggs. Out in the wild, though, that's what the animals would eat, would be the raw eggs from bird nests.
So who eats the eggs?
A lot of them. They, it just go into their diets, like even the little monkeys and, you know, just, there's a whole bunch of them that get that in. Even like up in the aviary, there's a lot of birds that eat other bird eggs and stuff. So it's just part of the diet. And now some of the animals do get live food. The crickets here are not fed live because crickets will jump and get out and go all over. But what they do feed live, we have, these are wax worms, and these are mealworms. So they're different kind. A lot of the little monkeys would be eating stuff like that if they were picking at the bark on a tree, so that they would have in their diet. Here comes one that wants to get over the top. I think I lost a couple of them today too, that they crawled away.
And that one.
Where is there one there?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, I think it dried up.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Yeah, they were crawling all over the place before. And then some of the animals will get vitamins in their meals. Most of the animals don't need the added vitamins, but if they do, it's a dry vitamin like this that will get put into their food. Now we have one animal that's in this building that they don't have anywhere else in the zoo, and it has a very special diet that nobody else in the zoo eats. Do you have any idea what that might be? What that animal is?
Hmm? I think it's the sloth.
The sloth? Well, no, the sloth would get fruits and vegetables. Yes?
The bat?
Which bat?
That one's trying to get out.
Yeah.
Of
it. No, fruit bat eats fruit. But you got the right answer. The vampire bat. Yes. Vampire bats only eat blood. And this is cattle blood that they get. And it comes, they'll keep it frozen until it's needed, and then it's unthawed. And then it gets fed to the vampire bats. How do they eat that? Good question. This tube, there's five of them in their area, and there might be a couple more that just have water in it because they'll drink water. This is upside down, and I'm holding it upside down so that the blood doesn't come out, all right? There's a little trough in here, and the blood goes in that trough when it's turned the other direction. And the vampire bats, you'll see them in the enclosure, they'll fly to the ground, and they hop over, and they start licking up the blood. Vampire bats do not, like they show in those awful movies, suck blood. When they host on an animal, they will make a little cut with their tooth. They have an anticoagulant in their saliva that lets that's something that makes the blood go real easy, flows real easy, and then it comes out, and then they're able to lap it up. They only drink like 6 teaspoons of blood a day. That's their whole diet. They need those animals alive so that they can still eat. So that's why they don't take a whole lot. Vampire bats are very small. Yeah, it's okay. The vampire bats are very small, so they don't eat a lot, which is a good thing. But they've been experimenting in the medical profession with that anticoagulant in their blood to help people that would have problems with clotting. So something that might come out, you know, but it's going to be very beneficial. Now, this is another thing that the keepers use here, and they use this in other animals also besides just here in the small mammal building. All of them here have a little transponder chip that's underneath their skin, and that helps identify which animal is which. A lot of people now are doing that with their pets so they can identify them. So if I'm a bat and I have a little transponder chip, the keeper would take this and push this little button here that I'm pushing, and then just run it over here, and then a number would pop up. And they read the number, and they can make sure that this is Johnny Jones or Freddie Mac or Fannie Mae, and then they know which one that they need to have and make sure that it's the right animal that they need. Whether they're going to be doing like a blood draw, maybe sending it to some other zoo, you know, that they would use that to identify the animal. And now I have a question for everybody. How many of you have had your parents or your spouse say, do you find something to do and stay out of trouble? I bet you I have. People have told me find something and stay out of trouble. They do that with the animals too. They give them enrichment items to help keep them busy. Why do you think you have so many toys? So you learn and you can be active with your mind? Well, they do the same thing with the animals. We don't give them our marker. to go out and mark things up. They will actually take the marker and they can make marks on like cardboard or things and put them in, and it has the smell, because these are all the scented markers. So it's going to have a different smell out there. The smell you have when you come in is because these are scent marking animals. They're out there smelling all the time. We'll use spices and drop those and stuff just to have a different smell for them. They can use something as simple as this and make a fruit kebab, where they would add like pieces of fruit onto this and have it hanging where the animal would have to grab and get the food off of there. And this comes off on you, and then it gets like on a skewer, and you can put the food on. And then even something like these little puzzle toys that they have. Maybe put these in by the monkeys and put like crickets in here or mealworms. And they have to figure out, you know, how to stay on here and hold on and grab and get something else, because it's keeping them busy and it's giving them something to do. Yeah. What, honey? I know. That's what happens. And then I put something on top of them and then they're not moving anymore. It just happens, you know? So do you have any questions about any of this? Yes, ma'am.
When you were talking about a vampire event, it reminded me of that Blood-Sucking Bird book that I have.
Blood-Sucking Bird?
Yeah.
Book? I didn't. Mom doesn't know about this Blood-Sucking
Bird.
I'm sure they're out there.
I don't know.
Go Google it.
Okay. Any other questions? You got me stumped because I have not heard of that, but that doesn't mean anything.
The
Illabilly
Sapsucker.
Any other questions? No, well then thanks for coming today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.